Our next topic is population ecology. From last week, you'll remember the definition of a population. A population is all the individuals of a species that live in the same geographic area and are able to interact and interbreed. Population ecology is a subfield of biology that deals with how populations change over time and how populations interact with the environment. Population biologists generally study a specific population in order to better understand how to sustain it and promote its survival. Your textbook introduces population ecology in Chapter 9 by telling the story of the gray wolf in Yellowstone National Park. In the early 1900s, there were 300 to 400 wolves living within the boundaries of Yellowstone National Park. Then by 1926, there were zero. What happened? Well, there were several things that happened. First, intentional overhunting. The United States Predator Control Program killed over 136 wolves from 1914 to 1926. Also, habitat destruction. Cutting down trees to build farms limited the wolf's habitat. Third, starvation. As humans in the area overhunted the wolf's primary food sources, elk, deer, and bison. In fact, gray wolf populations were completely extirpated from the entire western United States by 1930. Zero wolves. In the 1980s, biologists had confirmed sightings of wolves that had migrated into Montana from Canada. Armed now with an understanding of the importance of predators, a project began in 1994 to reintroduce wolves into Yellowstone Park and into the regions of Idaho. Interestingly, I actually worked in the largest wilderness area in Idaho during the time that we were preparing for the wolf reintroduction. The Yellowstone and Greater Rocky Mountain area wolf reintroduction program has largely been successful. In 2002, the program reached its goal of containing at least 300 wolves and 30 breeding pairs in three different recovery areas within Montana, Idaho, and Wyoming for three consecutive years. In fact, in 2012, the wolves were delisted, so removed, from the federal list of endangered and threatened species. These are the species protected by the Endangered Species Act. As of 2015, there were more than 1,600 gray wolves in the northern Rocky Mountains, over 500 of which were in the greater Yellowstone region, and just over 100 of which were in Yellowstone National Park. Definitely a success story that actually resulted in many positive changes to the wolf's ecosystem, as documented in your book. And I encourage you actually to check out the Yellowstone National Park website or some of the other websites dedicated towards wolf reintroduction. Notably, though, as I mentioned, the wolves of the Northern Rockies are no longer protected by the Endangered Species Act. And indeed, the Endangered Species Act itself is currently under attack in Congress. So what's to become of the wolf, and then also what's to become of the Endangered Species Act, is still a little bit up in the air. I encourage you to learn more.